What is the angle between the hour end of the clock and the minute end of the clock at 5:30? How many times the minute hand and the hour end of the clock crosses each other in the span of 12 hours? Question like this comes in a lots and lots of competitive exam, and knowing how to solve them is really important. And in this video, we will learn how to quickly and easily solve questions like these. So let's begin. Hello geniuses. Before starting this video, let me ask you, have you ever played the game named Flappy Word? And if you loved it, how about a math version of it known as Flappy Math? This is a really new and exciting game in which you can progress by quickly calculating math questions. This game is paid, it costs a really low amount, but I have collaborated with the developers of this game, and there is a Google form link in the description of this video. You just have to go and fill that form up, and to the first 100 people who fill that form up, I will send them a coupon code with which you can download this game completely free. And also, if you don't get this game free, it costs a really low amount, you can download it easily, and if it increases your calculation speed, it is worth that money, and it is also really fun to play. So do try this game out. Now let's come back to the video. So to solve clock hand problems, let us start by learning some straight up facts. And these straight up facts are simply straight up questions. So let's start with some simple facts, and then we'll move on to some really important facts too. So the dial of the clock is circular in shape and is divided into 60 equal minute spaces. This is what everybody knows. Now a minute hand covers 360 degrees in 1 hour. That means it covers 360 degrees in 60 minutes. So divide these two, what we get? 6 degrees. So it covers 6 degrees in 1 minute. Now in 12 hours, the hour end covers 360 degrees. So in 1 hour, it covers 30 degrees. And if we divide this by 60, we get every minute, it covers half a degree. So a minute hand covers 6 degrees in a minute, and a hour hand covers half a degree in a minute. So just keep these things in mind, and if you forget it, just calculate it from the basics just by looking at the clock. Now here comes some really important facts from which direct questions come. Okay, so in a period of 12 hours, both of these hands, that is the hour hand and the minute hand, makes an angle of 0 degree, that means they coincide 11 times. Makes an angle of 180 degree, that means they are in a straight line 11 times, and makes an angle of 90 degree and any other angle 22 times. This is a really important information, and question from these three facts comes directly, like how many times it crosses in 24 hours, just double this amount. Okay, so keep this thing in mind. Now also, if you have some confusion, here is a clock simulator link in the description of this video. You can go to that site and just move the dials and see how many times they cross each other to get a visual feel of these facts. Now let's look what happens every hour. Every hour, both of these hands coincide once. They make an angle of 180 degree once. They make an angle of 90 degree and any other angle twice. This was easily deductible from the previous facts too, but just keep in mind what happens in a hour. Now only one thing remains, but before that I wanna tell you, in this video we are only covering the correct clocks. That is, the clock works properly. There are question types in which the clock gains or loses some minutes by every hour, and you have to tell the answer to those questions. Those are incorrect clock problems. In this video, we are covering correct clock problems. But let me tell you, if you are clever enough, you can solve the incorrect clock problems using these facts too, because you just have to take the account of the minute gained or lost in those movements of the clock. So you can also try those incorrect clock problems too. But in this video, we are just covering the correct clocks. And the formula which now I will tell you works only for correct clocks. Okay, so if you have given time like 5:30, okay, and you have asked to find the angle between the hour hand and the minute hand, then there is this simple formula for it, that is half modulus of 60h minus 11m. So for 5:30, in place of h you will put 5, which is the hour, and in place of m you will put 30, which is the minute. Solve this. What we get? 15 degrees. So at 5:30, our hand and the minute hand makes an angle of 15 degrees with each other. So with this formula, you can solve lots and lots of clock hand problems. Okay, now let us solve some questions, and with that we'll mark the end of this video. Now the question is, at what time between 5 and 6 o'clock the hour hand and the minute hand coincide? That means they make an angle of 0 degree with each other. So with the information I just gave you, pause this video and try to solve this question and then look at the solution. Okay, so it is really simple. In place of the angle there, just put 0. And see, we have asked between 5 to 6. So the time would be 5 something. Okay, so in place of h, we will put 5 and we have to calculate the m. We get m as 27.27. This 0.27 is some seconds after 27 minutes. So the answer is that approximately 5:27, they will coincide. Okay, now here is another version of this question. At what time between 5 to 6 o'clock, they will make an angle of 90 degree with each other? How will you solve it? It is similar to that, but here keep in mind, they make an angle of 90 degree twice every hour. So in this case, you have to take both of the cases of mode, and it is really simple. In one case, you will simply open the mode and don't do anything, and in the second case, you will simply add a negative sign in front of it and then solve. So these two will be both of the cases. So for the first case, you don't do anything. We get 10.9, which is 10 minutes and some seconds. So approximately at 5:10, they will make an angle of 90 degree. Also, if we add a negative sign and then solve, we get 43.63, which is 43 minutes and some seconds. Okay, so at approximately 5:43, they will also make an angle of 90 degree. Now, here is a homework for you. At what time between 5 to 6 o'clock, they will make an angle of 180 degree. That means they are on a straight line. So how will you solve it? What case of the modulus you will take? So try it yourself, because here there are no two cases. They make an angle of 180 degree only once. So there are no two cases. So which case of the mode you will take? That is the problem for you. So try to solve it, and if you get the answer, write it in the comments for others to look at. So now at the end of this video, I just wanna thank these people for joining channel membership. It helps a lot continuing this channel. And do download the really fun game named Flappy Math from the link in the description of this video. So thanks for watching this video, and always remember that math is everything.